Hello everybody, it's John here, and I'm going to do a total project breakdown today on the Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Remix project. So first I want to start off with what's new. I'm going to talk about the new launcher that I coded as well, and I'm also going to break down the project at pretty much every basis possible, to be honest. So first I want to start off with what's new. It's been a minute since I've released any content on here at all, so I could see why some people would be worried that the project ended or something like that. Trust, I haven't stopped. I just had a whole bunch of different things come up in my personal life, so it's the reason why I've been away for a minute, so bear with me. I'm not going to do any edits on this, mainly because I want to get all my thoughts out, and I'll try to go over everything as best as I can. So I'll just start off with the new stuff, so the people who want to just watch the new stuff can watch, and then I'll explain it in more detail, everything past that, so everyone who wants to watch all the new stuff can just get that out of the way. So since I've been back from my break, the things that I really started on most were enemies. So I started going more into detail with the enemy models, remaking some of them and remastering them for the project. So right here I have the entire scene in our testing scene with all the remade enemies so far. So we have pretty much, I forgot how many in here specifically, I could check real quick. We have 7 remade bosses and 34 regular enemies. So that's quite a bit of them I remade. All of them I've done myself here. Yeah, I've remade all of these myself. Alright, so we'll go through all of them. First off, there's the Jafar Genie. I've added some changes to his textures and stuff. Like you can see, there's like a little wind effect on him. I'm not too sure how clear that is, but it's more clear in like his actual level. Let me see if I can find it. Oh, my brain's going blank. Oh, there we go. So like somewhere like here, I could just throw Jafar in here. Not in there. This is. Alright, so if I throw him in here, you'll kind of see what I mean more with how he fits with the environment and the darkness. So you can see he has a little shimmer effect on it, and then I have like a little wind effect going on over his body. Alright, so a lot of these are going to look different inside of their actual environments, but as far as overview goes, I have them all in here. Got Jafar Genie, we got the Storm Rider. This one was pretty, actually I could just, one second here. Alright, stop the music, I'm going to start the scene up. Oh, actually, it doesn't have music. So we'll continue it there, we don't have music. I thought it did. Okay, so we got our Storm Rider. They're all animated and remastered already. So I have these here. I think that one's called Thresholder. Prison Keeper. I'll go on the first person. Grim Reaper in its first form. Dark Thorn. We have Cerberus there. Large Body Soldier, Watcher. There's a lot of them. I guess I'll just show them off more than say each individual one. You can see I kind of did like a little magma effect for these little boys as well. Ice effect on there, on this material. And each every one of these in here have all their animations imported already. I just haven't set them up in here exactly, but there's quite a bit of them. And that's pretty much all I really did since then. But then again, there were a lot of breaks, like I said. So, but then again, this isn't a small feat. Over 50 enemies in this area? No, about 50 enemies in here? That's not bad at all. For I did most of these enemies in like this past month. So I was doing like one heartless a day or two a day, depending on how I felt. There's still quite a bit left, but not too many. Okay, so that's what's new with the project. And the other new thing is the launcher. Now the launcher, previous builds that I've made, I've always just done on Google Drive and sending a link. So I thought it'd be more efficient if I just made a launcher for the game. Let me go delete the files real quick so I can show you how it is from the beginning. So I would start up the launcher here. It's gonna, it's gonna have an error apparently. Okay. There's no way it's broken. Okay. Well, maybe I shouldn't have did that. Give me 1 second. I can restore what I deleted on here. Maybe not. Oh, yes, I can. Okay. Okay. Alright, so well, I can't really show you the setup because it doesn't work apparently. I guess I have to go ahead and code something. I didn't see what was wrong just exactly. But this is after the setup. So after the setup, you can change what version you want. This is all kept on a server as well. Well, not technically my server, but online. It reads data from a link and it determines what versions are available. You can select what version you want to download, then you can install it, and after you install it, you can play it from here and play the game. The app itself also auto updates, so whenever I have an update, I can push one out and it will update the actual launcher as well. The setup isn't hard. You just select the path of what you want your game files to be at, and then it would basically store all the game files and launcher files in one place, as well as any kind of save files, because the new version of the game will have a new save system. It's going to be able to cross-build your save files. So say you have 0.08 save files, that transfers over to 0.09 build files. That's a new save system I'm working on. That one's more streamlined because it'll be saved into a text file. And you just be able to change that text file or just copy it and give it to someone else. And there you go. You can share saves, edit your save files, manage that kind of stuff. I explain it more in my our Discord. So we do have a Discord. The link should be in the description for the Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Remix lower Discord. Bear with me, it's been a minute since I've done a video, so I'm gonna mess up a little bit here. So you can ask questions, you can request things, give me feedback on builds, we discuss development things here. So like, I usually post like pictures of while I'm developing things. You can give me feedback. I also post videos of new things that we're doing or things we're trying out. You can pretty much do a lot in here. And then I also, of course, you have builds here where you can download the builds whenever I release them. I also give people the choice to vote. This is the only vote I've done so far. Should the world map use your custom ships or just stay as the high wind? People want custom ships, so when gummy ships are made for the world map, you'll be able to use your custom ship on a world map. I'll put more stuff to vote on as I develop the project, but that's an example of what we use the Discord for. So next, I'll go over the process of making the project. So Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Remix is a standalone Unreal Engine project made for a PC. I probably will not be putting it on any other platforms, mainly because those require development kits, which cost money and licensing and all that extra stuff. So it'll probably be only on PC. I highly recommend purchasing any of the versions of Kingdom Hearts 2 before you play this version. Support the original developers. Do not want anyone who hasn't have a copy of the game to play this. So this right here is how long the project has been in development. I have taken a lot of breaks between the times, and it's also more of a fun project for me than it is serious work. So don't expect me to be full time working on this. I have a life. Everyone has a life. I have things to do outside of this. I do this for fun because it's fun. I like to do it. And all the other developers on the project like to do it too. So there's no point in rushing or anything like that. I do it at my own pace. And that's what you get. You get what I give out and what I can put in to the project. As you can see, this isn't even counting all the hours, but so far it has been 683 hours on the project, in this version at least. Today I've been on here for an hour. The project started on December 10th, 2019. It's been a long time. There's been a lot of progress since I started working on this bad boy. And I think it all shows here. So, as far as blueprints is a way to code in Unreal using visual instead of like writing out a script like this. Like here, I had wrote out all the script for the launcher, but in Unreal they use a blueprint system, so you don't have to really write code, but technically you are still writing. It's just visual. So things like this, it's more visual, setting up lines, setting up your variables here, and you get that. So I'm gonna go through quite literally probably every blueprint on here. All right, so we'll start with collectibles. As you saw, I have the chest. I haven't made any more chest models, but as far as the chest blueprint goes, I believe it should still work. Oh yeah, it certainly worked, but it was backwards. All right, so I have a variable here that tells it if it was already opened. That happens for chests that have already been opened. Of course, when you save your game, you don't want to get items twice every time you open a game. I also made a list, a data table of every material in the game, and you can get every material in the game on here, and it will collect it when you open up the chest. So I walk up to this, it'll give me Alcacum Plus, as you can see in the top corner. Got our pause menu. It's not functional just yet. I haven't messed with it in a minute. But I designed this more off of the 0.2 one, since I thought it looked more closer to the Kingdom Hearts 2 style as far as pause menu goes. All these numbers are dynamic. I'll be able to modify these. Currently the playtime and money work. So this save file, I've actually played for 18 hours, and that's just like between testing features out and stuff as I work. 68,000 money. And it will go up if I were to drop more money in here. So let me unpause. All right, so say I were to drop some money in here, it'll go to Sora and it will collect it. You see how much I've earned up there in the top. And it'll go up and increase as you add more. So did 30. And then, it, of course, it increased here in the menu. And my time has also increased. Alright, so we're gonna, yeah, each and every one of these have their own code and their rules. I've made them glow and inside of materials. Next I have, I kind of forgot I did this, but this actually vibrates the controller when you use a drive form. I'm obviously going to add more depending on what you're doing, but yeah, this actually works for when you're doing drive forms, it vibrates the controller. Data, these are the save files here. World info, this one tells the game what area you're in and what world you're in, and that affects this pause menu here. It just replaces this stuff with that data. I have this on every level, so it tells it what where you are and what world you're in, so it can set all that stuff up. World map worlds. To be completely honest, I actually don't remember what this does. I think this has something to do with the world map itself. I'm pretty sure it does. That's just a guess though. So we'll open up the world map. We won't save that. Well, I don't think I've opened this level in a minute. Oh, never mind. I was gonna say it make materials all over again, but it didn't. Yeah, actually, I have no idea what that blueprint does because I do not even see it in here. Okay. So this still works. I have a kind of have it set up. It's not really completely set up just yet, but it does let you go through the world. All right, I'm not gonna lie, that was kind of loud, but so we got all the worlds here. I haven't really made like the lines to connect them yet. You should be able to mess around it. As you saw, the actual gummy ship worked. For now, I'm gonna find that audio and turn that off. Copy and then delete that because that was kind of wow. All right, so yeah, I got the got it working. You can dash around and it kind of floats around as you do it. And they all let you get your triangle when you get close to them. So that world map kind of works there. Alright, so persistent data, this all this is going to get redone because, like I said, I made a new save system where I'm going to use more of just saving the data into a text file instead of using encrypted file saving. So you can easily edit the files and share them more effectively, since I want this to be more compatible with other people and being able to change the game to how you want it to be. These are just all the things that are saved. Difficulty, world events, timestamps, abilities unlocked and equipped, your items. Basically, it's just a save file, literally. Literally just a save file. Now we can move over to game modes. These are just different versions of things I put on the map. This one's using the world map game mode, which makes it use the gummy ship instead of like Sora or something. Third player, that's just the default Unreal one. No player one is if I don't want any player to be played in that level. Like in the main menu, you don't want to be attacking with Sora and the while the screen's being covered over by the main menu stuff. And then just the regular Kingdom Hearts 2 final mix game mode. That one's what I use for regular players, so I could spawn the pretty much any player on that one. I have a player controller. Player controller just manages the players. I have it set up your times, the music system. You can swap out your people on this menu in this blueprint here. I also use it to get the closest enemy. I haven't messed around with that too much yet because I don't want, basically right now I have all the characters like Sora, Riku, Donald, Goofy, they all do their own tracking and stuff, but I thought it'd be easier if I could just mainline it into one system. I haven't messed around with it just too yet, though, so not yet. Music system. I have three different ones. The world ones do, basically it lets you play the world theme and the battle theme. So it switches between both of them based off of if there's an enemy in the area. The single one only plays one track. So like it'll show the intro and the loop for the world map song here, Twinkle in the Sky. And it seamlessly fades from the intro and the loop file. So they're all split into two different files for audio. The intro to the song and then the part of the song that loops over and over. So I split those up and I have a blueprint that I use to blend them together as they end off, basically. So you have a perfect seamless loop and have its intro as well. I have pretty much all the songs on here already. We're also dual mixing the songs, so they're a mix of the Kingdom Hearts 2 on PS2 version and the remix tracks. I feel like a lot of the remix tracks lose certain instruments that the PlayStation 2 version of the game had, so I like had it where we mix them together and they complement each other in what ways they can based on the track. Epic's Game Store. This is just all the assets that I use from the Epic's Game Store. So like other content packs, I basically just put them into this little folder so I don't mix them up with the files that I've done. And if I have to use any of this stuff, like I use Good Sky a lot, so this makes a blueprint sky. You'll see Good Sky using a lot of the levels that I have. Like a Hollow Bastion should have it too. So Good Sky is a plugin to make skies. I figured that it looked best and it doesn't take up too much performance. So I feel like it fits the Kingdom Hearts style a lot. That's why I use it in a lot of things. Pretty much every map has the blueprint for the Good Sky, and it's a plugin from the marketplace that was free, I believe. But I feel like this one saves a lot of performance and it's not too demanding, but they still look decent enough to be, you know, skies and they move and stuff like that, so. Music, I already went over that. Systems. Okay, now this is where it gets more in-depth. Event manager. I think a lot of this stuff doesn't, I can't really explain a lot of those things because a lot of these complement features in a very specific way. These here are just spawners, like if I want to spawn a bunch of enemies at once, or spawn them when you walk past a certain amount of boxes or anything like that. That's what I use these for. These are more development ones. Same for there should be a, I thought I had a testing one here. Oh, testing's here. Same for testing. This one's my favorite one here. It spawns like Lingering Will and he teleports everywhere. Oh, I kind of forgot that. Play music there. Alright, I'll turn that off for now. That's my favorite one so far. It just spawns Lingering Will everywhere. He follows you. I think it's funny. That makes me remember the Lingering Stalker. I call it Lingering Stalker and like I'm seriously debating on using that, not gonna lie. Where he's just like hiding around the corner, and then like Lingering Will is just like hiding behind a shadow and just comes out and attacks you randomly in different spots of the whole game. That might be a whole different mode, but I think it'd be fun. Or more funny, if anything. Alright, so I have NPCs as well. Kinda. I don't know why he's not showing here. I do have him in the testing area, so you can kinda see how he is there. So if I were to play him in here, I can press E to talk to him. He says, welcome to the testing area. I spent quite some time developing this project. Hope you all have fun and checking out the mechanics. Then you can just press any button to exit out of it. He'll turn to you and talk to you whenever you interact with him. So I use that to test out NPCs whenever you're talking out on like the actual worlds. We just use Roxas as a placeholder. Movies, that's just all the you know, like Sanctuary and the opening movie for the game, so those are some of the actual videos. Don't worry about that. That's for mega scans. Particle systems. I haven't done many particle systems. We had someone else on a team who did all the particle systems that you see in the game right now. He no longer works with the team. He had some personal things come up, so he had to leave. But we do have a lot. These are different packs that he made at different dates. So 2020, pretty much did them in different parts of 2020. And he has all the drive transformer effects and stuff like that. Pretty much all the particle systems were made by him, and he made quite a bit of them. It's very, very needed. I think I have to simulate it. Yeah, that one's like a... Holy crap, that was loud. Yeah, a lot of these kind of need to start the game to do it. Alright, so there's just a lot of particle effects, honestly. So it's like parry, blocking, recovery from a save point, leveling up, Google, both save points. Just a bunch of different particle systems. All the dry form ones. All the magic here. We got the all the magic ones, which they look phenomenal, not gonna lie. Yeah, there's a lot of particle systems, pretty much. I haven't done too many yet. I'm gonna move on to that sometime. I'm not too sure. I might go for that last because I still don't really know how to use them too well, but I'll go back to it eventually. Next thing I'll go over will be sound effects. That's pretty self-explanatory, just all the sound effects for different things. UI, user interface, that's pretty much just all the simple stuff. Lock on icons, the reaction command triangles and stuff like that. I'll remade all of them in Photoshop, just cutting them up, making new stuff. Don't worry about what the mic was also, don't worry about that. Just stuff like that. All the UIs, just that's all this is. Different menus and stuff like that. Oh, oops, didn't mean to do that. just like blueprints that make the load menu. So it's just very, there's a lot of stuff that goes into it. Yes, this has 99 slots, of course. Then the blueprint is a monster. I will say user interface gives me the most trouble when it comes to menu, mainly because I don't really like how Unreal's input system works when it comes to user interface, so I have to like manually make my own interface with like using button presses, and it takes a lot to do a single menu with that method, especially since I make it support controller and keyboard and mouse. Something like the main menu here, that one's like the pinnacle of craziness here. Got the menu animations here, just a bunch of stuff like that. Then when it comes to the blueprint of this bad boy, this one's a monster. This one's a monster. This is just the main menu when it comes to user interface blueprints, and I tried to organize it. Tried as a big, yeah. Then they all have short things inside of them, like a simple thing like this, setting up the new game. It's just a lot going on. Now we'll go into our models. I do have levels for those as well. Keyblades and weapons. We got all the struggle bats. A lot of these keyblades don't have keychains just yet. I'm gonna add them in there since I've figured out how to do chain physics. I've already done a few of them to have chain physics on them, but it's pretty much all the keyblades and stabs and shields that we have so far. They're pretty much, all the stabs and shields are pretty much done. All the keyblades are pretty much done. They just need keychains, which won't take too long. I'll have to focus on that one day and just lock in and make them all. But as far as the shields and stabs go, those are pretty much done deal. Like, they're almost completely done. I only think there's like two or three of each left. Oh, this is the testing battle area, I believe. Oh yeah, this is test battle area. So the, as far as the AI goes, I have them all set up in their unique ways. They do their idle stuff. They'll attack as well. I don't know why these aren't moving towards me yet. Oh. Yeah, I don't know why they're not moving. Oh, I know why, actually. I'll have to do with the... I had to put a navigation bounce. I have it set up a certain way. But for now, we'll just make it crazy numbers so they can move around with the... Alright, so they'll move against me. I can lock on to them. The lock-on system works. Although a stretch I see here, but I can fix that up later. But I lock on. If I get too far, it should unlock. Yep. Then I can attack enemies.
Yeah. This is it.
Now the aerial combat isn't completely done yet, but I kind of started it.
It's over.
Reaction commands work as well. Oh, I'm stuck. Okay, yeah. Reaction commands work, kinda. But mainly because they all can do a bunch of them, I still have to work on that until only one of them can do reaction commands. And then one of the things that I still have to work on really is being able to push these guys, because I'm not gonna lie, being able to push them has not really worked just yet. I gotta work on that. I think that'll do a lot for the combat, to be honest. Then right now I temporarily use Fire Aga for explosion on his ground combo because I don't have a particle system for it yet. So dry forms also work, as a lot might know.
Back off.
They pretty much transform instantly.
Give me strength.
And I can attack with them, still do the same things. Alright, so.
Give me strength.
Master form doesn't work that much because I still haven't finished aerial combat, so this one pretty much useless right now.
Give me strength.
Final form. This one's kind of coded. Well, I just changed the enemy on accident. Yeah, this one still has some work to do, but. Alright, so. You can play as Riku. This is just the one from the final fight. I still have to re-rig him and do some changes, but you can kind of play as him right now. Play as Roxas as well. As well as dual-wielded Roxas. So the main problems I really have is just pushing. Well, actually the shadows, I think I was working on the push system here, so I kind of can push them here. I think I was testing it out on them, so you can, I can kind of push them out the way, which kind of works. Yeah, I think this feels a little bit more fluid with the shadows than it does with the dust. Alright, so could also spawn in Donald and Goofy. I don't think I had them do any attacks yet. At some point I did have them do attacks, but I think I turned them off.
This is it.
And I haven't been able, oh yeah, actually I can push these too. I think I was still working on the system, but they can kind of get pushed. But that's been a problem I've had with the project. Pushing enemies, they kind of turn into brick walls when you walk into them, which is not what you want. Especially when attacking, because it just stops you from moving.
It's over. Give me strength.
Anti-form.
Give me strength.
Yeah. Alright, so any form and limit form. This one kind of needs work, but I mean, I got them kind of working, so.
Give me strength. Give me strength.
I don't remember which one that was.
Give me strength.
Okay, there we go. Alright, so.
Yeah.
You can do.
Yeah. Yeah. Back off.
Pretty much all the moves with this. Then I can do. Oh, he just flew away.
Yeah. This is it.
That can do some of the limits.
Yeah. 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 Take this. Yeah. 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 It's over.
All right, so. Alright, so that's pretty much it for that as far as combat goes. I'll delete that. Alright, so when it comes down to characters and their blueprints, there are some monsters too, like Sora's here. Sora's blueprint might be the most complex blueprint I think I've ever made, ever. Now, this one has so much stuff, it kind of looks like a map. Very, very, very complex. Each feature is in their own bracket. Try to do every feature split up by itself so that it's more organizable, but this bad boy gets very cluttered very fast, especially when it comes to his ground combo, stuff like that. Rotating towards your target, do your first combo, and then each of these individual ones also have their own little branches. So like if I were to click on the ground combo start here, this has a whole sequence as well. So like first it checks if it's locked on. If you're locked on, what does this do? You'll get the distance between you and the enemy to determine if you're gonna do a close attack, a crowd attack, and a distance closing attack. Yeah, those are the three different attacks that you can do. So like slide dash for a distance closing attack. A close attack would also be like a one that's really close, that's not a distance closing, would be a slap shot attack. Or if you're trying to get a crowd, you can do the dodge slash, or like a finisher that clears out. It basically changes based on how many enemies are close to you, how close you are to them, and that kind of thing. So it's very dynamic, like the actual Kingdom Hearts 2 is with that aspect. Everything's very planned. Next thing I really need to work on is aerial combat and refining the ground combat when it comes to that thing. I think I've pretty much covered everything, to be completely honest. I guess I can show you, to finish it off, show you how I pretty much remake this stuff. So I have several tools I use. One second here. So I have my Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Remakes folder here. I have models here. We have first I use all my tools. I use this tool here to get all the extracted files from Kingdom Hearts 2. And I edit this file to have the files that I want, and I make presets for them. And I've made quite the preset list, honestly. So I've had objects and characters. I sectioned it out. And I pretty much have all the enemies on here. I just do it as I go. And this plays their animations and has a model. I hit this button, it'll export the animation from the PlayStation 2 formats. And then that's how I get them. Oh, that one doesn't work. I kind of forgot about that. Okay, that crashed it. That one specifically didn't work, so it crashed. But after I extract them, I have to put them all in one folder. So like with the models here, we'll do enemies, Aerial Knocker. I haven't touched this one yet, but these three files is what I'll get from the game. And then I'll use Noises here. And this has a plugin for Kingdom Hearts 2 that I use. I just load up the file. And in here I can export it as FBX or whatever traditional format for Blender to use. So I would then open up Blender. Oh, well, not that. I'll then open up Blender. And I have a tool that imports it. So if I wanted to do the creeper plant here, there's the model. This model, and then I can just throw the textures on this later kind of thing. And when it comes to the model, I can import the animations as well that I have. So now you got all the animations from Kingdom Hearts 2 and the actual model. And then Obviously, you just reference it at that point, remake a whole new model, and then rig it up to the skeleton, and that's a remastered model there. And once you remodel it, you got a fancy model for Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Remix. Boom. That's why I make my materials and stuff like that. When it comes to materials, I've made a bunch of different presets for the materials. So this is my materials folder. Have ones that make death fades for dark areas. So like dark doors that go into oblivion, I have something for that. I make materials for pretty much everything. I have a bunch of base ones, stuff that emit light, some of them that are masked, some of them that parallax objects, some tessellate objects. Pretty much a material, a master for everything. And then once I have a master for it, drag it on here and I can slide and adjust values for anything and make dynamic materials based off of what I want. And just, I can modify all the stuff that I want. So like if I wanted that to be brighter, if I want it to be more shiny, less shiny. Those are just small examples of the potential of using these kind of materials to make stuff. As far as texturing goes, I just upscale the textures for the most part. There are some I have remade in like Substance Painter or Quixel Mixer or Photoshop. I use Photoshop to do some stuff. So like I just find something like, we'll use an example. So we have this one here. Alright, so if I can grab this thing. Alright, so upscaled one. This is upscaled, this is not upscaled. You can tell clearly which one looks better. So I just upscale those textures. If I need to use those, sometimes I don't even use the texture. I'll just like make materials by myself. Like with this, like I didn't need to use one of those textures. I just have some basic little ones that I work with for the most part and then just modify them to look like a color and they work out great. Okay, now I think I completely broke it down. I'm not too certain when I'll do the next build. Not just sure yet, but next build I do have plan on having that launcher out, so the Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Remix launcher will be out, and I do plan on having the aerial combat done as well as some more areas. I guess I could also show some areas that I have worked on for everyone who has not seen. But they could still be building lighting and stuff. I haven't finished these areas, but a lot of the areas have been made in the project. So you can kind of see. So I have a lot of different areas remade. That took a lot of time. Oh, it's still compiling stuff. This probably wasn't a good idea to load all the maps in the game. All right, but yeah. No, I might as well save those. There's a lot of area. I'll go through them all just so you can see all the different ones. All right, this one's compiling. All right, yep. I made a little underwater effect under here. that kind of blurs the screen as you go, as well as ripples. A lot of these areas aren't done yet, but they have a whole bunch of care and time put into them, so. Ballroom. Oh, that didn't get finished. I like this one more. Oh, I forgot I also made battle gates. I plan on having battle gates be a thing in this project. So you can go back and replay some of the story fights, but harder. Alright, well, that one's taking a minute to load. Here, nice one. See, this is why I like using that good sky pack that I got for free. That bad boy is nice. It can make some decent skies that aren't too performance heavy. This one I haven't touched too much. I think I literally, like, when I first started making maps is when I touched this one. This one isn't even using that sky pack. That's how I know it's old. It's using like the regular Unreal Sky. I haven't touched this one in a minute. Oh, I kind of forgot I made them in here. This one I'm still working on. This one's kind of done, but not too much. I see like the occlusion edges here are kind of like pixely. I'll fix that. This one here is like a material that fakes darkness. It's actually a cube and it fakes darkness and it stops you at the same time, so makes it feel like you're going into a dark corridor. I'm gonna go ahead and close this and try to give it some performance. Got our library here. Library. Oh, I kind of forgot I made the little test for actual gummy maps too. I don't think I've really finished this one, but I guess it was more of like a placeholder anyway. I think this one actually has a track on it. There, so I can use like the actual gummy ship. Yeah, I got it shooting as well. So this is what I'm gonna use whenever I do gummy ships. I use that whenever I do that. So that's kind of coded. I guess the only thing I really need to code after that is just the actual paths for whenever you're going through the actual gummy mission. So that actually works too. Forgot I worked on that. This one's, I have a lot of work done into this, but I haven't finished it just yet. I was doing them like one house at a time. Then I got the actual house here. These maps take a long time, so I try to pace myself with the maps, but I feel like a lot of them have been done to a good amount. Like even this one, I really like how this one looks. Like being able to see everything. Even a little bad experiment here. This one, I like how this turned out as well. I have the prison keeper in here. That's when I was making the model. So I was testing out materials in here. Yeah, I think it complements them very well in here. So, go ahead and get rid of him in here. I haven't done much this one, but I did make the little conveyor belts actually move you. And they actually do speed up, I believe. Let me see if I can... Yeah, I had to do all this. Alright, I actually don't really... I'll have to look into that more later, but I kind of forgot how that works. But it actually moves you. Yeah, so I got it to actually move you. So that conveyor belt actually does move you. Yeah, using the blueprint to push you back. And it also speeds up too, so I can make it faster, like 5. Yeah, I'll delete this song so it doesn't blast my eardrums out. But I made it faster just now and it moves me pretty fast, so. Obviously, I'm going to use that while we're fighting so that he can make you go faster when the conveyor belt goes faster. Yeah, so that's working. Yeah, you'd be dead now. It moves so fast, it pushed me through the wall. Okay. I think it's 5. Alright, so yeah. Stat level. Hollow Bastion, I've done... haven't done much on this area. I kind of got like the basics outlined, and then all these empty spots would be where the houses would go and like the crane and stuff. So this area is not too bad. The actual castle, I have a level for that too. I'm still working on that model, but I think the castle actually looks pretty nice. So like here, this is my little test area. And the castle looks amazing here. I haven't finished it yet, but from what it looks like already, it looks nice. I was testing Sephiroth in here too, actually, his boss code. Because I did make some boss codes. This is using the PlayStation 2 model. And I made his system. Like I said, these codes for the people and stuff can get real complex real quick. So he's, even with his basic moveset and stuff, this is humongous for his code.
Show me your strength. That's enough.
So his code kind of works.
Enough. enough.
But yeah, as you can see, I kind of got his AI working and stuff like that. A lot of the bosses do have some nice AI working. It's just, I have to refine them. So I feel like I have a lot done on a project in total. It's just, a lot of it just needs refinement, which isn't a bad thing. So we have a lot going on. And pretty much when it comes to code, it's just really copy and paste at that point once you get the main systems down. So I got a lot of them, like even Zaldan, I believe, if I go to his level, I think I had quite a bit worked out for him too. Okay, yeah. Alright, so yeah, his AI kind of works too. I just, a lot of it's just literal just replacing animations and changing some stuff up, but it's not really hard things to do. It's just more of remaking the models that's so time consuming, to be honest. Guess I'll continue with the maps. We're doing Halabashian. As you know, I finished this area as well. Garden Assemblance. I like this area a lot. I did quite a good job on this one. This might be one of my favorite areas I've made so far. One of the areas for the data battles. Oh, and I kind of forgot I did this too. I actually made the Thousand Heartless battle. I wonder if it'll actually crash if I try to play this now. Let's see. Oh, actually, no. Yeah. Alright, so yeah, that one kind of works too. Transport remembrance. I like how this area looks as well. This one has the spawn boxes, spawn enemies as well. So if I were to go down this hallway, I can spawn enemies in the boxes there.
Yeah, back off
and fight them. So
this is it.
We got Land of Dragons. I like how this area looks as well. I think this was the one I made right after taking my Unreal course, and that's when I started baking lighting and ambient occlusion and that kind of thing. So this area turned out pretty nice. I like how this one looks. Same with the Emperor's room. Where's that at? Throne room. Yeah, I like how this one turned out a lot too. This was when I first started learning about building lights and stuff like that. And I was playing around with it, and it got some really good results. Checkpoint. There's nothing here. Bamboo Grove. This one I kind of finished, but I kind of want to go back over it. I feel like a lot of the stuff is going to need to get going back over after I'm done with the project. Or after I'm done with this phase. Not the whole project, but for now I'm going to make everything and go back over it. So we got some bamboo trees, and I got to move them with the wind and stuff, but I feel like a lot of these stuff here, like this kind of stuff, it looks kind of 2D, but mainly these ones here, like the actual 2D bamboo, I want to go back over and replace. You got like the burnt city back there. I got the water moving through it. So it actually doesn't look too bad. Sarah doesn't look too bad. I feel like a lot of it's just cleaning up some of those assets I was just talking about. This area, it's building the shaders real quick. Alright, so this area here. I definitely have to redo this stuff back here. I was just throwing it in as placeholder. Mainly because these trees are 2D and the actual thing is 2D back there too. The plants and stuff. But I got the tents like moving a little bit, I think, with the wind. It's very subtle, but you can kind of see it if you get close. It moves with the wind on the tents. So this area is kind of done, but not much. I gotta go back over it. Same with the mountain trail. I kind of don't like how the rocks look here. But give it 1 second, it's gonna load up. It's compiling shaders. Yeah, so it kind of looks good, but I want to go back over it with some stuff. I feel like one thing I have to do is go over these with like blending tools I've made for other scenes. I just haven't gotten around to do it on these ones, so that these aren't just like cuts and they actually blend together. I've made some vertex tools for that I'll mess with and blend them together after a while. This village, I think I did this one's done, I believe. I like how this one turned out. Oh, I forgot I threw him in there, to be honest. It's compiling shaders. Shaders are done now. Yeah, I forgot I put the stone right in here, not gonna lie. That thing looks massive in here. Yeah, that thing looks massive in this area, holy crap. But this area is pretty much done too. Another one of those fake boxes that make it look like darkness. Then there's the actual cave itself. Some of these areas have been scaled up a little bit bigger, so you have some space. Like this area is a little bit bigger than normal. Yeah, so there's that. Holy crap. There's so much more to go over. This video is probably going to be long as crap, but if you're this far in, I applaud you, to be honest. I think I'm an hour and 12 minutes in right now. Yeah. Honestly, this one doesn't look too bad. I haven't touched this area in a minute. It actually doesn't look too bad. Maybe I have to redo the sand here, but... this area is nice. Same here. This one doesn't look too bad. Might have to redo that sand. This doesn't even exist. Building the shaders and still 100 shaders left. Another one of those fake darkness boxes, although this actually has darkness in there, but it would just look like that, which isn't ideal. Fire in there, save point. Here it looks nice. Then we got this area, the lock. All right, still loading. As I said, this area look. Oh, actually, it did blend it a little bit. I was gonna say it looked better with the blend, but I guess I kind of did that here and just didn't really. Maybe it needs to be blended more, but I can kind of see it there. Then I got this glowing. I kind of forgot about that. That looks nice. Oh, I kind of forgot how nice I made this door look too. Underworld entrance, Lake of Souls. This one isn't done yet. I think I saw that the lights there. You can see very dark sky with some clouds. Then I like the little glow effect I put on these. Make them look awesome. Then there's Valley of the Dead. This one, I might need to work on this one more, but it's not too bad. Got stuff fading in through there. that roof, caverns. These doors don't look too bad either. I think mainly I want to touch up down there and like this here. But, Port Royal, I don't think I've done much on it. Oh, actually, yes, I did. I thought I didn't do much, but I did actually. Like the moonlight nook here. Actually looks pretty good. Got the little sky here, the moon up there. There's actually water out here too, for this water. Got those treasure chests. Fake lighting in there. Same here, fake lights from the sky. And these actually give you the correct items too. I set these up already. Yeah, those give you the items already. Powder store. Now, prepare, these crates actually do blow up. I think they're loud. I think they're loud right now, but these actually do blow up. So I got this here.
Yeah, take this.
They actually blow up, and they got physics as well.
Yeah.
I like how the water looks though. The water looks real nice here.
Yeah, it's over. Yeah.
So yeah, that one blows up. I actually like how they blow up a lot. This is just that save point on a wall, I believe. Yeah. Not much you're supposed to have here, except the ship's not here, but just walk over there. And then of course, the interceptor, there's not much done on this at all. I really like how these cannons look. And then of course I was whenever I built the models, I put them in their environment so I can make them look as good in their environment as possible. So Grim Reaper's here. Alright, so there's that. I can just delete him up out of here. I'm pretty sure everyone's seen this earlier, but oh, actually, I think I did some Twilight Thorn fights here too. I think I coded them just a little bit. All right, so we got of course, the dive in the heart.
Yeah.
Alright, yeah, there's that. I think I got Twilight Thorn kind of done too. Let's see how it goes. Hopefully it loads. I think I started working on his basic AI. It's basic AI, it might be. But it's kind of hard because I don't think you can do aerial combat yet because I haven't made that yet, so can't really fight him. But you can definitely see the animations and stuff, I believe. Well, if it will open. Yeah, there we go. Alright, let's see. Oh yeah, I can hit him like this, right? Yeah. Oh. I missed. Oh. Alright, so yeah, I think it just had basic AI worked out for him. That isn't much. I think I skipped completely over Space Paranoids. I didn't do much on this one, but I think it was kind of nice. Yeah, there we go. It's still compiling, looks like. Oh, there we go. Alright, so I think this area looks pretty nice, though, for what it is so far. Looks pretty nice. Still got much to work on in this area. I think this is the only area done in Space Paranoid, so yeah. Getting pretty close to the finishing point of all the maps, but as you can see, there's been plenty of maps made and in progress. So LA2 between just compiling the shaders right now. Oh, now this actually looks way better than I remember. Yeah, this looks way better than I remember. Got this here. Yeah, so, and then I made it rain in this area. I think the rain really just brings it out, to be honest. Of course, there's the finals in this area. Fighting. Now, I haven't been able to really get the organization codes to work right, so I haven't added them in just yet, but once I get their codes working, I should be able to get their models in pretty easy. So we got Riku, Sora.
Give me strength.
Then I kind of got this area working right, kinda. But their animations are kind of, I still gotta work on it, but. Yeah, I still gotta kind of work on that, but. Not much is done here, but that skyscraper, that did take a long time to do, I'm not gonna lie. And that took a long time to do, I'm not gonna lie with that one either. That bad boy, it took some time. But so you're kind of somewhere there. Then of course there's this area. The shaders are compiling right now. Okay, there we go. Oh, I definitely forgot it looks like Metal Man here. I have no idea what happened that make it do that, but. So it looks like freaking Metal Mario in here. Like, literally. Yep, this area is pretty big. This model is a PS2 model. I haven't remade it yet, but I still think the area looks nice. Now this one, I believe, has that cutscene in it. These are using the PS2 models here, so this area hasn't been remade yet, but I was using it to test out the cutscene. Like the sword slashing the buildings in half. I was using it to make that cutscene here. Okay, this one has quite the bit of shaders, I'm not gonna lie. I think it's because it's not using, each material has its own thing. Okay, that's probably gonna take a long time to compile all those. Actually, it's going pretty fast. As I said, it's slowing down. Only area we really have left is Timeless River and Twilight Town stuff to show off, and that should be it for the showcase of quite literally the entire project. I feel like a lot of the project is done is just refinements and working out the kinks. Alright, so I actually don't remember how to do this. Oh, there we go. Alright, and there's that. That's the animation for that. Then there's the other one where I'm slashing the buildings. It's compiling shaders again. So after you get knocked up here from that, run up this, get knocked up. Then you just start here. Then the buildings will be floating up there. Yeah. No, I actually don't remember how I make it do the other one. I totally forgot. Let's see. Why can't I click this? Oh no. Oh, there we go. Alright, so yeah, there's that. And then, of course, there's that rain here, too. I like the rain. So now on to Timeless River. There's only one area. Then I think there's quite a few areas in Twilight Town, and that should be it. I forgot Timeless River Sword is here too. So you can actually use Timeless River Sword. Oh, and I was testing Mickey Mouse following you. Now you got all your party members following. So Timeless River and Twilight Town has quite a few areas. Back Alley. Now Twilight Town has some good shaders here and lighting. A lot of these areas aren't too much done, but they got some good stuff started on them. That looks really good. I was working on this area. Haven't finished this one yet, but then this area is pretty cool too. I like this one. On the outside, it's just a pill. Alright, then we got the Sandlot. This one's more recent. I did a lot of work on this one recently. I think this was the most recent map I was working on. So actually, it looks really good. Station Heights. This one's not complete, but I got a lot of the little buildings done here. And I like the little 3D tile here too, so. Station. I actually think I made it the door slide open when you come next home. Oh, yep. You can enter this little area to go in here. room. Oh, that was my chair. I had to lean. All right, so we got the white room here. I like this area a lot too. Tram Common. I think this one was the one that took the longest to do in Twilight Town. I remember it being very, 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 very long. But I think I actually did finish this area. Even the little interior stuff. Oh, no, I didn't. Only thing I didn't do was behind this, the wall. Everything else is done, mostly. One of the best looking areas. And then finally, the underground concourse. This one I might revisit for these little brick things here. I might revisit for that, like remake those, but other than that, the rest of it looks pretty good. Because, like, I don't know, I just think they look kind of flat here. Maybe if I update the texture or something, it might look better, but I think pushing it out 3D would make it look good too. This whole little area got the lights and stuff. And that's, Death Screen. I got this one started too. I was still working on it, but now there's a Death Screen. I don't think I showed this one off yet, but. And I think that's it. I will see you in the next update, and feel free to put any comments down. If you have questions, I'll answer them. That's pretty much it. See you until the next build, because that'll be when I make another video. I'll make another video when I release the next build. That'll be combat will be refined. You'll be able to do aerial combos. And I might end up implementing a lot of these enemies and stuff that I showed at the beginning of the video that were finished. And there we go. Have a good day.